Haters ball, man. 24/7 around the clock. That's how they do it. Insiders in the North Boston Grove, right here. In the city that we call Dodge City. Got a lot of hatred around this place. Need a radio sour like a lemon envy. So full of bad vibes and embedded jealousy. Notion, sticky memory. Time that they flush that bad driver. From the very first time, we never did agree. You a real joker in a bad, bad movie. Mask in disguise, that's your philosophy. But now they shine bright like a morning sunny.
Now you ain't no me. Now you ain't no me.
And shift right back. Before I picked up the mic and started writing rhymes, I could alter my form at any given time. Shape, shift, shape. Back to the start when I first started shape shifting. After class, school really wanted me kitchen. There was little D running for his life with his heartbeat bumping inside. Moved into a cheetah, them cheats couldn't keep up. 60 miles per hour was the speed, I was G1. Going straight into my mother's arms. Even tried to morph into a car, a bus, a shiny gold bar. Even break the hitman heart. But my mama couldn't see it, she just laughed. Giggled to herself, you were crazy boy, get in the bath. And you better scrub harder, the talk to be fast. I was like, nah, I'm a superhero, I'm honest. You should've seen me early, shapeshift, are you watching? Let's go back, back, back. To when I used to shapeshift and shift right back. Before I picked up the mic, started writing rants. I could alter my form at any given time. Shape, shift, shape, shift, shape, shape, shift, shift, shape, shift, shape, shift, shape, shift. I'm a bird, I'm a tree, I'm a bike, I'm a plane on the ground underneath your feet. I'm the rain on the sky, I'm a cloud, I'm the sun, I'm a star. Shoot hoops through satin's rings, walls in my palm, I'm a bear, I'm a dog, I'm a chair, so get off. I'm an action figure, but I'm not trapped in a box. I'm free, free with the world at my feet. I'm an 18 theme as I'm running down the street. If you're feeling hungry, I'm your quarter pound of cheese. But if you're feeling angry, I'm your punch back. Only weed high, still on the sheets. I still read a Beano every night after tea, cause I'm drawing inspiration for the next thing to be.
As we alter, morph, switch, I am lawless, you're
missed. Sport for choice, now my cranium aches, cause my brain's in overdrive, all over the place. Inspiration's running through my body's powers. Tell me now, what would you do? Would you morph into the devil? Would you help improve the foundation of society? What would you lose? Or would you morph into a yard and help your mama to move? I need some new shoes. Pick up the mic, start writing rhymes. I could alter my form at any given time. Shape, shift, shape, shift, shape, shape, shift, shift, shape, shift, shape, shift, shape, shift, shape, shape, shift, shift, shape, shift.
Step on up and show your hand. I know it, now I can see clearly, I folded, I shouldered too much weight, I hold it, too much pain, and it destroyed me, and then rebuilt me, and now it can feel me, it follows me everywhere I go, but it can never break me, now I know, I was lying to myself back then, but the truth was reaching in vain just to hold on to them once again, the memories seem to blend, my enemies and friends seem to vanish in the wind. One step closer to your dreams. Does it mean everything in between? World gotta hear my voice, cause this is my music, my thoughts, my life. It ain't a song no more, it's a sacrifice. It's an offering of everything I got. Like everything I am reflects everything I'm not. So much
NBA here on 2K Sports. A Monday night broadcast of the NBA. It's Chris Webber and the Sacramento Kings going up against the Toronto Raptors. And that's a wrap for me here in the studio. Now let's send you out to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. I'll see you again at halftime.
We welcome you to our Monday night broadcast of the NBA here on 2K Sports. For the Raptors, happy to be here in Toronto right now in the midst of a nice homestand. And many happy returns to Chauncey Billups, now healthy and in the lineup and ready to roll.
That was a short leave of absence, and he's back in the fold now, Kevin. We'll see if he can pick right up where he left off.
Yeah, and in the grand scheme of things, his injury wasn't that big of a deal. I mean, a little bit longer, and it could have been.
Now Sacramento starting five. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Weber. Then there's Robertson. Then it's Richmond. And it's Lucas in at the three. And for Toronto, they've got Carter. Charles Oakley out there with Elijah Warren. then it's Tracy McGrady, and it's Phillips in at the point. And so off the tip, it's Toronto. Tracy McGrady on the wing. Jacks up a three. The shot, no good. And the Kings the other way. This game coming after a loss against the Pistons.
And they were very soft defensively in that game, guys. I just didn't think they brought the energy and the effort it takes to win in an NBA game.
Well, no critical stops when they needed them. The effort was very pedestrian at best. So you combine those factors and you can't get it done in terms of winning a game.
The dish now to Carter. Up top, Olajuwon. 17 points in his last outing. Toronto on D. This game against Sacramento is the first time they've met this year.
Well, they thought they'd handled this club last year both times, but they actually split the two season meetings.
And stolen by Phillips. Throws it up high. Well-placed alley-oop pass into the layup.
Boy, how about that nice soft finish on the alley-oop?
It was. He didn't try to do anything foolish.
No, no reason to act like you're in the dunk contest. Just got to get your 2 points and get back on defense.
That no matter what building they were in, this is a team they should have beaten both times.
It's probably got a little something to do with the fact that they're just not a very familiar opponent. I mean, that's one way to look at it. You can't get in a much better position for the three than that. Everything was right on target. It just didn't fall.
Carter, the pass to McGrady. Back to Carter. Olajuwon inside. Cousins is there. Olajuwon, no good.
And that's just one of their first four field goals to begin this game.
Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Dwayne Casey.
Well, guys, forcing turnovers in the open floor is one of the things he'd love to see his team be able to do today. He said, we can sneak up on people defensively if they're not careful. And before you know it, a steal, a layup, and we look good on the offensive end of the floor, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. Well, guys, give us your thoughts on that.
Well, you know what? I think the game plan for a lot of teams, really good teams, starts with good deep. So it's pretty much what I expected to hear.
And for this club, that's the way it should be. I mean, they need to send a message defensively right away. When you take it to your opponents on the defensive end of the floor, it sets the tone early. You can't get too loose with the ball down on the low post. Too easy to steal it.
McGrady gets the reach-in call. That's his first foul. Here is Robertson, averaging 19 points per contest. Cousins against Olajuwon. Four on the shot clock. Fires the three.
It's a a monster throwdown. Wow. Boom.
Now that was unbelievable, folks. That is major bounce to the ounce there.
Yeah, he can fly, guys. There is no doubt.
Yeah,
that
no,
guy can take off.
No doubt he can fly. What do you call it, Clark? Bounceability, I believe.
Now here is Carter. Playing New Jersey, he was nearly unstoppable. He's covered by Richmond. Fades away. Rattles the shot home. Carter's got his second bucket of the night.
Guys, you're not going to get away with that kind of defense when he's got the ball. I mean, you got to do better than that.
From the high post, And the Kings check on two more. Here's McGrady. He's coming off a 13-point game against New Jersey. Fires from the line. Vince Carter the bucket on the assist by McGrady. 6 points for Vince Carter. Phillips against Robertson. Outside for Richmond. Launches a three. Here's Weber. And it's good. Terrific work on the offensive glass to make that one work.
Well, those are like 3 points. I mean, great effort. Stay with the play. Continue to fight.
The leaner. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. And he makes the first. Second free throw, no good.
Boy, how about the touch on that pass? Lobbed it up there nice and soft, feathery.
Yeah, looked like it made Steve for a pretty... The replay.
How's that for finishing with flavor?
Absolutely fantastic.
I think he was.
It's been back and forth. Really good battle here.
Kings call timeout, they're first. And you look at Carter, among the league leaders, fourth in scoring. He's in full bloom. Look at the Lakers. Right now they're off to a fast start. First place in the conference.
Caught a lot of folks off guard. I mean, they've made a big-time leap forward.
Yeah, they sure have. They've made great strides since last season. And give them credit. I mean, they've worked hard. They've earned this. And I think they've done it through a really aggressive team play. They've been selfless in their approach. And they've worked. I mean, they have worked really hard to get to this point.
Right up. And Carter with the basket on the assist by McGrady. 17 points for Vince Carter. Here's Robertson. 6 points for him. And stolen by Billups. It's one-on-one. Goes for the alley-oop.
Tipped.
The Kings trailed by five. Pass break, here we go. Holler. That's good. And Robertson with the assist.
That's really what gave them some distance with that lead.
You know, Steve, knowing your history in the game, I know you love to see shooting like that.
Be reined in a little bit.
Now, here is McGrady, picked up by Robertson. Shot clock at five. Carter kicks to Elijah Wan. Over Weber. And so he draws the foul on the shot.
Second on the foul. Shooting.
confusion.
And that one misses. And he's good on the second. Up high to stop the alley-oop.
Tell you what, guys, they are really playing well.
Yeah, up double digits already.
First quarter. It's the Raptors up 9.
Pretty good start defensively. This put advantage, and that's how they built this lead.
And they forced turnovers, but they've taken care of the ball themselves. So that's a.
And that concludes the first half. We'll be back shortly live from the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto.
Hello and good Monday night. Let's get right into our HP Halftime Report. Toronto leading against Sacramento. They've been active defensively. Steals, deflections, jumping to passing lanes, forcing miscues. Vince Carter not having much difficulty scoring against the Kings team. At the break, 30 points and has been getting after it on defense as well. No let up on either end of the court. And slugging it out so far, the Sacramento Kings. Right now, they sit with the second best record in the conference.
And as we begin the second half, first half wasn't even close, guys, and we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. Digit ball game. Look at Vince Carter in this game. I mean, he's been everywhere. Tracy McGrady subbed in for Chauncey Billups. And then for Sacramento, Richmond comes in for DeMarcus Cousins. Now McGrady defending. It's tipped. Tries to snap the cold streak. Weber can't hit. And last year's playoffs, so entertaining, Clark. Some competitive series. Steve, really an open field.
Yeah, it really is. There's so many good young teams in the NBA right now, and some of the older, more talented teams maybe on the way downhill. So this is going to be fascinating the next few years to see which teams can break through and get to that top level.
Everything's falling now, and this lead continues to increase.
Yeah, it's just way too hard to keep up with a scoring pace like this. I mean, and that's why the defense is having a tough time.
Richmond for 3. Offensive rebound. Robertson against McGrady. Robertson dishes to Richmond. Off his leg. And let's see it again with the spike slam can.
Just pouring it on and adding to this big lead.
Steve, they're playing outstanding basketball, and they've been doing it all game at both ends.
Here's McGrady. And here's Carter. Sacramento grabs the miss. Lucas has got his fifth rebound right now.
There isn't anybody in the building that didn't appreciate that throwdown.
Well, Steve, that's as fancy a finish as you could possibly get.
A serious degree of difficulty on that one.
NBA legend Rick Barry wrote that he thinks the players today are much better ball handlers than in his era. Do you agree, Clark?
Yeah, I certainly would. I mean, you think about it, players nowadays idolize the Magics and the Iversons of the world, and they have a lot more good ball handlers to look at and pattern themselves after.
Weber can't hit. And here's Toronto. They've allowed just 7 points here in the fourth quarter. They get it back. Carter outside. Covered by Martin. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. In what ways do you think the players of Barry were better?
You know what? It's interesting. I think players in the era of Rick Barry understood how to play more. Without the ball, especially. Guys now are so locked into having the ball that they're not as effective without it.
The first one falls.
Boy, this team does not waste opportunities at the foul line. They make the opponents pay when they foul. If they get sent to the line, they're cashing in.
He hits both from the stripe. Here is Robertson. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of troubles.
And they're playing with so much energy offensively, the ball is really moving.
These points in the paint.
Here's Robertson. Now McGrady defending. Robertson passes to Lucas. Back to Robertson. Dishes it to Lucas. This one for three. Rebound by the Raptors. McGrady's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one.
Well, they've built a big lead here so far, and a lot of it has to do with how well they've been rebounding.
Yeah, every time they make a stop, they're securing the rebound, and that's really allowed them to get out to this lead.
Here's Richmond. Foul call that time.
They put a lot of mileage on that player. Old age comes a little quicker. I mean, you think about Kobe and KG, Tracy McGrady, Jermaine O'Neal, Richard Lewis. There's just a lot of mileage on those wheels.
A nice shot by Elijah Wan. Here's Robertson. And going back to the prep to pro players wearing down, and some of it is simply the accumulation of those 82 game seasons, but also, some experts think that sometimes the body of an 18-year-old player just isn't ready yet for the pros.
And Kevin, you and I both think there's something to that. I mean, in pro football, rookies have to have completed 3 years in college. It gives them a chance to prepare themselves for the transition to the pros.
Here's Carter. Rebound by the Kings. 1:41 left in the game. Carter against Robertson. Barry's the easy one. Robertson's got four this quarter. 1:33 left to play in the final quarter. Now McGrady. Here's Elijah one. That's good. Great play set up by T-Mac, Tracy McGrady. Now McGrady defending. Elijah Wan with the block. And he's able to get it back.
Tracy.
And so he makes both from the line.
Well, you see so many great European players in the league now. And one of the things the NBA has talked about in the past is creating a five-team division in Europe. And obviously a lot of logistical hurdles involved, but wouldn't that be interesting?
Robertson against McGrady. They get it again. Here's Lucas. And he lays it straight in.
Kevin, it's really hard to deny this guy the offensive board if he's got even the slightest position inside. He'll take advantage of any little slipper you give him.
And DeRozan kicks to Carter. He's covered by Richmond. Richmond is tagged with the reach. That is his first foul of the game. Would fly to Europe and play all five teams twice. And then they'd be done with their international obligations.
I tell you what, that would be one monster of a road trip, not only in terms of miles, but also in terms of culture and experience. I mean, there's challenges as well, time zones with regard to broadcast times. You know, U.S. players might not want to play abroad. I think overall, it could be a really exciting development, but a lot of questions yet to be answered.
McGrady dishes to Elijah Wan. The jump hook, count it, and the foul. And so he's picked up his final foul, and he will sit for the rest of this game.
This is where their depth becomes such an asset, Kevin. He's going for the remainder of the game, but fortunately, they're able to field a very capable replacement.
The Kings are making a switch. Cousins is checked in. Shooting one. And that one falls for Elijah Wan. Here's Robertson. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's McGrady in for the dunk.
Another bucket, and they are just pulling away here now.
Yep, no doubt about it. They're sprinting to the finish line.
Here's Richmond. And the rebound goes to Martin. Here comes Carter. Over Robertson. Vince Carter the bucket on the assist by Martin.
And that ought to do it. That should seal the deal.
Yep, I agree. Closing it out with relish.
And so Toronto takes this one, but by a big margin. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never...
Now you ain't know me. Now you ain't. fire, the lightning.